phenomenal job. David, who those in Montreal will definitely know from the schools, David Smajevitz, our communication and outreach manager, and our host of tonight, and also our program director, Phil Frey, who's going to be doing, as always, an amazing job. So thank you to our team. Very proud to have them, and they're very thankful to have them. And to all of you here tonight, thank you for joining. Thank you for supporting JNF. I hope you're going to have an amazing time, and I wish you a lot of luck. Let's get this party started, Phil.
All right, guys. So before we get started, couple of simple rules, advice you need to follow to win. You don't follow these rules, you're not going to win. You're not going to be qualified to win. First and foremost, you need to have two devices on hand, computer, tablet, iPhone, Android, doesn't matter. You need one to watch this video. You're watching this right now. You're in the room. Clearly, you passed step one. You have that one device. You need a second device. And on that second device, you need to have Kahoot. Most of you have probably seen it a million times since we've been doing school from home. It's a free app. It allows you to answer all the questions. In just a minute, a screen's going to pop up with all the questions and a pin. You're going to enter that pin into the Kahoot to join the actual event. We're going to give you a few minutes to do that. Before we get to that part, a couple of small things. You need to use the name on Kahoot that you use to register as. If you're registered as Sam Cohen, it has to be Sam Cohen. If you change your name for a fun name, we can't match it up to the registration. You're not going to be qualified to win if you do win. Rule number two, you got to keep yourselves muted throughout the events. You have any questions, any technical problems, anything at all, just type it into the chat. Somebody's going to get in touch with you as quickly as possible, and we will try to address all of your issues. Aside from that, screen shares. I know you guys know the hacks to get in there. Don't do them. If you start trying to hack the screen share, we're going to have to stop the game, delays things. You're just going to ruin it for everyone. So guys, keep it clean, keep it fun. We're giving away 5 random draws throughout the night. That means on top of the top 3 prizes you guys are battling it out for, we're giving away 5 random prizes throughout the night, gift cards to Indigo, and we're just going to randomly draw those names throughout the night. In the middle, the beginning, towards the end, whenever we feel like it. So if you don't think you're going to win the actual competition, don't just log out. You still may win some stuff at the end. We're giving away stuff all night. It's a clearance sale. So with that being said, guys, you're going to turn your attention to your screen, and you're about to see the Kahoot screen. Bear with me. So now you see Kahoot. You see the pin. The pin is 3415088. You have Kahoot on your second device. Type in your name. Olivia's got it. Ezra's got it. Alon's got it. Sarah's got it. Alexa's got it. Perfect. We're moving along. Technical problems whatsoever throughout the night, type it into the chat. myself, David, Galit, someone's going to get as quickly as possible to help you solve it. So once again, guys, we got 47 players in there. If I don't see the next in the chat, I'm going to assume everyone has it and everyone's ready to go. The music's turned off. Loud and clear, the music's turned off. You're only going to have to hear the annoying music when it's time to answer your questions. So guys, here we go. Jane of Canada, IQ Trivia, the challenge. First three questions are for 0 points. They're practice questions, just to get those fingers working. So here we go. Practice question number one. JNF is most famously known for what? Food banks, planting trees, building towers in Israel, being a great group of people. Whoever said we're a great group of people, I thank you. I appreciate it. I like to think of myself as a good guy, but the answer is wrong. We are famously known for planting trees. 0 points. Question number two, still worth 0 points. Here we go. Which app became famous for people posting videos of themselves and friends dancing? Snapchat, Facebook, TikTok, Instagram. Because when you're bored in the house and you're in the house bored, you gotta hop on TikTok. Here we go. Last question, 0 points. Israel's flag is made up of which colors? Blue and white, blue and blue, blue, white and gray, red and white. Mazel tov to the 41 people who got that one right. If you're not seeing the questions on your shared screen, it might be a Zoom issue. So you may want to log out of the event, log back in, and that usually resets the whole thing. So I'm going to assume everybody else. Jaden, not an issue. Take a second. Quit the Zoom. Exit the Zoom altogether. Come back in. You'll probably see the questions at that point. Now, guys, very important. If at any point you get disconnected during the event, you have some sort of technical issue, don't stress. You can log out and log back into the Zoom at any time. Log back into the Kahoot at any single time. You'll lose a couple of points from missing a question here or there, but you could still join back in at any time. So, round one, here we go. You know what, Jaden? I'm gonna give you a second to log out. I wanna get you something here. I wanna give away our first random draw before we get started. Let's give Jaden a couple of seconds to fix his screen. So, draw number one is going to, here we go, random draw. We're giving away to from Calgary, Edmonton, Manitoba, Saskatchewan. Random name in the thing. Here we go. Emmett Sobelman. Emmett, you just won a $20 gift card to Indigo. That easy. All you had to do was show up. So congratulations. We're giving away four more gift certificates throughout tonight. One for Montreal region, one for Ottawa, regional Ontario, one for Toronto. And at the end of the night, we're giving away the overall. Jaden, for logging back in, the pin is 341-5088. 341-5088. Again, guys, if you have any issues and you have to quit the Kahoot or the Zoom, log back in, just type in the question, ask me the pin, I'll pass it out to you guys again. So, draw number one is done. Guys, here we go. First question, worth some points. Let's do this. Which of the following animals are not a mammal? A walrus, an otter, a hippopotamus, a penguin. Penguins are actually neither mammals or amphibious, they're birds. So congratulations to the 25 people who knew that one. Guys, there's still a lot more questions, so don't get discouraged. And after the first question, our leaderboard is Maddie Berman in first place. Guys, keep in mind, Kahoot, it's time sensitive. The quicker you get that answer in, the more points you gain. Question number two, which Canadian-born NHL superstar is currently captain of the Pittsburgh Penguins? Sidney Crosby, Connor McDavid, PK Subban, Mario Lemieux. Sid the Kid. He's been captain of the Pittsburgh Penguins for 13 seasons. He was actually the youngest NHL captain to win the Stanley Cup. So congratulations to the 33 people who got that. Maddie, you're still holding up in first. Evan, you're climbing it up in second. Simone coming in. Alexa, Aurelie. Next question. Here we go. How would you write 1/4 as a percentage? 0.25%, 25%, 15%, 4%. Basic math. Don't fail me now. 25% for the 13 people who got 25%. I didn't love math either in school, and I actually went to a math-enriched school, so don't worry. There's still hope for you guys, too. Maddie, you're still holding strong. Simone's on a streak. David's on a streak. Abby, Rylan, on a streak, climbing up the charts. Here we go, moving along. Tim Hortons is to Canada as blank is to Israel. Starbucks, second cup, Israel's coffee, Aroma. With over 100 locations across Israel, you ain't going to Timmy's Hoes. You're going to Aroma out there. Congratulations to the 38 people who got that one. You clearly watched the JNF videos, which I told you are your cheat sheets tonight. David's climbing up in second. Aurelie's coming into third. Simone, Jordana's coming up the leaderboard. Guys, here we go. What do we celebrate on Tu B'Shvat? National Animal Day, Human Rights, Trees and Nature, Israel's Mountains. Trees and Nature, that's right. Tu B'Shvat has developed into an ecological holiday that reminds Jews of our connection to the earth and to our role as caretakers of the environment. And I'm sure for those of you who are involved in JNF, you get calls from us once a year on Tu B'Shvat. And next year, hopefully some of you will help us make those calls. Congratulations to the 45 people who got that right. Maddie, you're holding strong in number one. Jordana, you're still up there. Matthew Lidsky, you're up there. Aurelie, guys, keep them coming. Plenty more to go. What is the molecular makeup of H2O? Two hydrogen, one oxygen, one oxygen, two oxygen. One hydrogen, two helium, one oxygen, one helium, two oxygen. You ever seen The Water Boy? Bobby Boucher always told you. Some quality H2O, and that quality H2O is made up of two parts hydrogen, one part oxygen. Maddie, still hanging in there. Keep them coming. JNF was founded in what year? 1910. 1901, 1948, 1912. 31 of you watched the video, knew the answer, 1901. The Jewish National Fund was founded in 1901 to buy and develop land in Ottoman Palestine for the Jewish settlements. Congratulations to the 31 people who got that. To everyone else, don't stress, don't fret. We still got a lot more questions coming our way. Mr. Baker, you're climbing up the charts. Abby Green, you're up there. Aurelie, David, and Maddie, still sitting at the top. What do we get when we put three chickpea balls, tahini sauce, chopped tomatoes, and cucumbers into a pizza? Shawarma, ceviche, mafram, falafel. For those of you who've been to Israel, you go to any single corner, you're going to find a falafel stand. It's like the hot dog stands of New York. Congratulations to the 31 people who knew that one. Jordana is coming in hot and moving up to number three. We got Simone in number four. We got Aiden Baker at number five. David and Maddie, you're still sitting tight at one and two. What was the first campaign used by JNF to raise funds to build Israel? Planting trees, blue box donations, calling people at home, throwing parties. blue box donation found in homes, synagogues, and schools and remains the most visible symbol of the Jewish National Fund. You've seen these a million times, and if you haven't, I'm sure you're gonna notice them now. You take a penny, you take a quarter, you take whatever you can give, you put it on in there, and we all build Israel together. Congratulations to the 32 people who got that one right. And Aiden, you just climbed into number 4. All right, guys, we got one more question, and then you know what? Let's give away another random draw. Here we go. What is the name of the kleptomaniac monkey in Disney's Aladdin? Abu, Alu, Abu, Adu. Whether you're a fan of the 92 original or the remake in Will Smith in 2019, Abu is still your kleptomaniac monkey and Aladdin sidekick. Checking out the leaderboard. We got Maddie at number 1. Jordana's climbing those charts to number 2. Aiden at number 3. David's dropped to number 4. Simone at number 5. And guys, with that being said, do a giveaway. I'm giving away some gift certificates to Ottawa Regional Ontario area. So the winner from Ottawa/Regional Ontario is Zoe Newman. Zoe, congratulations. You just won $20 to Indigo. If you don't like books, they got plenty of other things to get there. Enjoy. So now, guys, we're going into the next 10 set of questions. They're about to get a little harder. So here we go. Which Jewish actor played this lovable snowman in Frozen?
Here's the buzz. Kids will blow dandelion fuzz, and I'll be doing whatever snow does in summer.
My favorite Disney movie of all time, The Lovable Snowman, is not just Jewish. Josh Gad, he's a singer, he's Broadway, he's an actor, he's Olaf. Congratulations to the 28 people who knew that one. So, moving along to the leaderboard. You got Maddie still at number 1, Jordana at number 2, Aiden sitting at number 3, Simone at number 4, Aurelie climbing her way back to number 5. Which sea creature has 3 hearts? A seahorse, a killer whale, a jellyfish, and an octopus. That's right, the octopus has 3 hearts, 9 brains, and blue blood. Congratulations to the 33 people who knew that one. Looking at our leaderboard, Aurelie climbing it up to number 4. Simone, you've dropped to number 5. Aiden, Jordana, Maddie, you're still sitting pretty. Keep the answers coming, guys. Here we go. According to the KKL website, how many trees has JNF planted? 200 million, 232 million, 246 million, 263 million. 246 million. That's a lot of trees. According to the latest numbers published by the KKL website, 246 million trees have been planted thanks to JNF. That's the number of trees that were planted by KKL JNF in the land of Israel during the last 118 years. Let's see where we get in the next couple of years, guys. 15 people got that right. Looking at our leaderboard, Aiden, you've made your way into number 2. Jordani, you've dropped to 3. Lucas is coming out of nowhere at number 4. Nathan's climbed it up to number 5. Here we go. Which of the following is a well-known Israeli breakfast dish? Avocado toast, shakshuka, falafel on a bagel, hummus on toast. If that gave you this answer, I hope you all remember. 44 of you knew it. Yes, it is shakshuka. Avocado toast, delicious, not the answer. Maddie staying at number 1, Aiden number 2, Jordana, Lucas, Nathan. No movement on the leaderboard. Here we go. In the show Friends, what excuse does Ross always use to justify his breakup with Rachel? They were on a break. Rachel and another man. Ross and another man. So I grew up watching Friends all the time on TV. This was my favorite show. I still watch the reruns. Apparently, it's the newest, hottest show on Netflix. So for 38 of you, they were on a break. Congratulations. Leaderboard stays the same. The questions keep on coming. Which of the following celebrities is not Jewish? Lil Dicky, Drake, Ariana Grande. Congratulations to the 36 people who knew this. Ariana Grande, she practices Kabbalah, but she never converted to Judaism. Congratulations, guys, for knowing that one. All right, Lucas, you've jumped into number three. Jordana, number four. Nathan at number five. Here we go. Who sang this Israeli summer hit? Give the video a couple of seconds to load in. Everything is Yo, Mr. Bob. 33 people knew that Static and Ben L brought us this summer hit back in 2017, and we're still blasting it today. So congratulations to the 33. The leaderboard has not moved. No worries. We're only getting to that halfway point. So thanks to JNF, Israel recycles this much of its wastewater, as stated by the Israeli Ministry of Foreign Affairs. 42%, 65%, 86%, 100%. 86%. Congratulations to the 17 people who knew that. According to the Ministry of Israel Foreign Affairs website, by 2015, Israel was treating and recycling 86% of its wastewater for use in agriculture, ranking Israel the number one global leader when it comes to water recycling. Within the next decade, Israel plans to reach 90% of water reclamation. So congratulations to the 17 people who got that one. Let's take a look at our leaderboard. Maddie, you're sitting tight, but Aiden, you're creeping up there. Watch out, Maddie. Here we go. What falling fruit supposedly inspired Sir Isaac Newton to write the laws of gravity? An apple, coconut, grapes, and orange. That's right, it's an apple. According to the legend, young Isaac Newton was sitting under an apple tree when he was bonked on the head by a falling piece of fruit in the 17th century. Apparently it was an apple. So, Maddie, of course you got that one. Which of the following countries does not share a border with Israel? Syria, Egypt, Jordan, Iraq. Forty of you knew that it was Iraq. Iraq is actually bordered to the north by Turkey, to the east by Iran, to the west by Syria and Jordan, and to the south by Saudi Arabia and Kuwait. So congratulations to you for 40 geography majors. Let's see how the points are ranking up here. Maddie's still sitting at number one, Aiden number two, Lucas number three, Jordana number four, Nathan number five. You know what, guys? It's time to do a random draw. Let's give away something to Toronto. T dot, let's give you away something. Who's it gonna be? Who's it gonna be? And the winner from Toronto for a $20 Indigo gift card is Ben Baker. Congratulations, Ben Baker. You just won yourself a gift card, $20 to Indigo. Congrats. We still have two more draws coming your way, the Montreal region and the overall everybody in the pot. So, one thing I should mention, guys, is if you did win a gift card at this point or in the future, and you win the third prize, you win the second prize, you win the first prize, We are going to ask you to forfeit your $20 gift certificate so that we can throw it back into the pot, do some more draws at the end, because at the end of the day, guys, we're here to win, but we're here to have a good time. We want to be fair. We want as many people to go home with something as possible. So once again, if you want a gift card and you end up winning one of the top three prizes, we are going to ask you to put your gift card back into the pot. Let somebody else win. Here we go, guys. Of all the great world religions, Judaism is considered the what? Second smallest, third largest, smallest, the largest. It's actually considered the smallest by size. According to a 2015 report, the largest religions in terms of size is Christianity, with 2.3 billion people. Judaism comes in with 10 million people. Nathan, you just climbed up to number four. Jordana, you've dropped to number five. Maddie, Aiden, and Lucas, you're still sitting in our top three. Here we go. With the help of JNF, which of these vegetables was engineered in Israel in 1973? The mini peppers, cherry tomatoes, apium, baby corn. Of you clearly watched your videos. I'm happy to hear that. And yes, it was the cherry tomato that was developed by Nahum Kedar and Chaim Rabinovich in the agriculture faculty of Hebrew University of Jerusalem. Thanks to JNF. You know what? I want to go off script right now. An apium, galit. What's an apium? I'd love to tell them, but I don't remember myself.
It's apricot and plum, but it's a more recent fruit, guys. It's been invented in the past years. Cherry tomato has been around for quite a few decades.
I'm more of an apple, banana, watermelon kind of guys, but for those of you who ever seen an apium out there, grab it, try it, message me. I'm dying to know what it tastes like.
I'm going to send you a few, Phil.
Let's check out our leaderboard. Adam Katz, you're coming in. Nathan, you're sitting there. Lucas, Aiden, Maddie, still riding it up.
Hey, Phil, should we meet our players?
After this question, who's sure. The most followed celebrity on Instagram? Taylor Swift, Kylie Jenner, Michelle Obama, Cristiano Ronaldo. Most followed on Instagram. You probably thought it was Kylie Jenner. Some of you thought Taylor Swift, although she actually is up there. Cristiano Ronaldo has held the top ranking of Instagram account followers with 240 million followers. Number one. Galit, who do we want to meet?
Well, I want to see these guys. They're like inching at the top there. Maddie Berman, Aiden Baker. Who are you guys? Lucas Warwick?
You know what? Let's do this. Let's drop the screen. Where's Aiden? Aiden, I'm gonna unmute you. Where are you?
Hey.
Aiden, what's going on?
Hi.
How's the family? For those of you who don't know, I actually did Aiden's bar mitzvah in Ottawa a couple of years ago. So Aiden, what's going on?
Not much. Bored in the house and the house bored.
Yeah, say the clean version. Don't say the dirty version. You're sitting at number two. You're still climbing the charts. You still have a chance at number one. Aiden, good luck. Say hi to the family for me.
All right. Well, thank you.
Where is Maddie? I want to find Maddie. Maddie, let's unmute you.
Hi.
Maddie, we're going sideline here. You're sitting at number one. You got.
Yeah, I just got like the last question wrong.
How are you feeling? You feeling stressed?
Well, I just got like a question wrong, which means I lose my streak, which like loses a bunch of points. So.
But you're still sitting at number one.
Exactly.
So you know what? Keep those answers coming. We still got plenty of questions. Maddie, good luck. We'll see you at the finish line.
Thank you.
All right. So we spoke to our number one, number two. We're going to come back to talk to the others in just a little bit. You know what? Let's get back to it, guys. Let's keep those points coming. Next question. Which of the following Great Lakes is the largest? Lake Superior, Lake Huron, Lake Michigan, Lake Erie. Superior is its name, and Superior is its size compared to the rest. Lake Superior is 31,700 square miles. Congratulations to the 31 people who clearly paid attention in grade 5 geography. Here we go, guys. True or false? Israel is the only country you can have a kosher McDonald's. Congratulations to the 16 of you. Guys, you're gonna be shocked, but the only other kosher McDonald's in the world is actually located in Argentina. Second floor of the Abasto shopping mall. Next time you're in Buenos Aires, grab yourself some kosher Mickey D's. Let's check out our leaderboard. Still sitting same. So let's keep them coming. In Modern Family, where do Luke and Haley get summer jobs working at together? A mall, a restaurant, a tennis club, golf, and country club. That's right. Season 8, episode 6, Luke and Haley get jobs working at Jay's Golf and Country Club. Congratulations to the 26 people who got that one. Lucas, you just jumped Aiden. Aiden, don't stress. Maddie, you're still sitting at the top. Here we go. Which of the following is not an Israeli invention? Waze, WhatsApp, ICQ, the USB flash drive. That's right. Although WhatsApp is huge amongst Israelis, it was in fact created in California and is actually owned by Facebook. So congratulations to the 16 people who got that one. For those of 25 you put ICQ, it was actually in the video. ICQ was this old school app before the iPhone, before Facebook. It was a little chat. You got this little dip-dip when you tagged each other. We used to chat on it all the time. And it was in fact invented by Israelis. Alexa, you just creeped up into number 5. Here we go. In The Lion King, Mufasa tells Simba that blank are always looking down on you from the stars. Himself, angels, the great kings of the past, all of their friends. The great kings of the past, as they sat in the field, father and son, after Mufasa saved Simba from the hyenas, he looked at the stars, he looked at his son, and he told them, you can always look up there to see the great kings of the past. Congratulations, guys, who got that one. Our leaderboard stays the same, and we keep on moving. On a standard keyboard, which is the only vowel not located on the top row of letters? A, B, I, O. Really sorry to the 9 people who didn't have time to look down at their keyboard, but yes, in fact, A is on the second letter of letters right next to the cap lock button. Congratulations to the 36 people who knew it, looked at their keyboard. Either way, you got those points. And our leaderboard stays the same. Here we go. The winner of the Super Bowl receives what trophy? The Stanley Cup, the Vince Lombardi Trophy, an Oscar, a Commissioner's Trophy. The Vince Lombardi Trophy, currently held by the Kansas City Chiefs, and it's actually made by Tiffany and Co. So congratulations to the 35 people who got that one right. Let's check, take a look at our leaderboard. Maddie, followed by Lucas, followed by Aiden, Adam Katz, Alexa Wise, you are in our top 5. Guys, we still have more questions coming, but you know what? Before we do that, let's give away another random draw. $20 gift card to Indigo. This one is going to someone in Montreal. Who's it gonna be? Who's it gonna be? Leia Abitbol, congratulations. You just won $20 to Indigo. Gift card. We're going to contact you guys. You're all going to get your gift cards, probably by email, maybe by mail, but we're going to be in touch with all of you guys in the next day or so to work out your winnings. And again, if you want your gift card now and you win later, do the right thing, put it back in the pot. Leia Bitball, congratulations. You just won a gift card. We have one more random draw, which we're gonna do at the end of the night. Guys, questions are about to get a little harder. Put on your thinking caps, because in what city will you find Israel's Silicon Wadi? Haifa, Ashdod, Tel Aviv, Jerusalem. Tel Aviv, Silicon Wadi, or as it translates into English, the Silicon Valley, is an area with high concentration of high technology companies on the coastal plains of Israel, similar to the Silicon Valley in the US and California. This is the reason Israel's nickname, Startup Nation. Guys, you ever go out there, you call someone at JNF, we're gonna set you up with all the tours, you're gonna see all the big startups, Waze, SodaStream, everything's out there, guys. And they're all out there in the Silicon Wadi. Congratulations to the 24 people who got that one right. All right, Maddie, you're sitting at number one. Lucas at number two. Aiden, number three. Adam Katz, number four. Alexa Wise, number five. Let's keep those questions coming. Here we go. What is the lowest point on Earth? Death Valley, the Dead Sea, the Grand Canyon, the Atlantic Ocean. Fortitude, you knew this. It is, in fact, the Dead Sea. Dozens of land areas on the Earth sit below the current sea level. The lowest land area is the shoreline of the Dead Sea Depression in Israel. Congratulations to the 42 people who got that one right. Maddie, Lucas are sitting at number two. Adam, Alexa. You know what, guys? Let's take a little break right here. Let's get to know our people. Where is Lucas? Lucas. Hold on, Lucas. I'm looking for you. I'm going to unmute you. Let's see how you're feeling. Unmute. There we go. Hello. Lucas, what's going on?
Not much. How are you?
All right, man. Where are you playing from? What area are you in? Which region?
So I live in Toronto, but I'm actually at a rental cottage up in Huntsville.
All right. You're a Raptors fan?
Yeah.
You a Leafs fan?
I don't really follow hockey, but I'd say
okay, yeah. That's a good answer, because if you told me you're a Leafs fan, we can't be friends anymore. Lucas, you're sitting at number two. You're right behind Maddie. You think you can overpass Maddie?
I'll try.
Okay. That's all you can do. Lucas, enjoy the country house. Good luck for the last couple of questions. We're going to see you at the finish line, all right?
All right. Thank you.
You know what? Where's Alexa? I've only been talking to guys the whole time. Talk to Alexa. Alexa, I'm going to unmute you.
Hi.
How's it going?
I'm good.
So where are you from?
I'm from... I'm from Thornhill.
Thornhill, okay. You a Raptors fan?
Yeah.
I love the Raptors, it's okay. Galit, any wise words for Alexa before we go into those last couple of questions?
Girl power.
Alexa, you're the only girl left on that chart, so you know, you gotta represent here.
All right.
Good luck, we'll see you at the end. Yeah. You know what? Before this leaderboard changes, no one gets left out. No man gets left behind here. Let's talk to Adam.
Adam, hello.
What's going on?
Hello.
How you doing?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. Where are you playing from?
Winnipeg. Yeah.
Go Jets. Way to go, Winnipeg.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure you're the only person from Winnipeg here with us tonight. What's the weather like in Winnipeg right now? Is it cold in Winnipeg? Is it hot in Winnipeg? I've never been to Winnipeg.
Today it's hot, 39 degrees.
39 degrees in Winnipeg.
It's really cold in the winter.
And you got better weather than I have in Montreal.
Yeah.
Adam, we got a couple more questions. You're right behind Aiden for the third place. Keep those answers coming. Good luck. And we're going to see where you finish in just a few.
All right. Thank you.
All right, guys. So the leaderboard is what we see. Let's get it back up there. Maddie, Lucas, Aiden, Adam, Alexa, everybody else, don't quit yet. Don't leave the room because you could still win some prizes at the end. Let's keep the questions coming. Aside from hockey, which is the only other sport considered to be Canada's national sport? basketball, baseball, curling, lacrosse. Thirty of you knew that. Galit, they know their sports.
They sure do. I did not know that, guys.
Ice hockey is actually considered Canada's official winter sport. Lacrosse is officially declared Canada's summer sport. Congratulations to the 30 people who knew that. And apparently Alexa knew that, who just climbed up to number 4. Congrats, Alexa. Which of the following is part of JNF's work to support the land and the people of Israel? Water solutions, forestry and environment, community development, all of the above. That's right, it is in fact all of the above. Although we're popular for planting trees, JNF helps build Israel in many other ways as well, from R&D centers to bike paths, water conservations to after-school centers for teens. Thanks to JNF, we're building Israel together. And you know what? We couldn't have done it without your help tonight, guys, for your generosity, being here tonight, your support. We thank you. We're going to keep building all together. 38 people got that right. Our leaderboard stays the same. Next question. In the movie Back to the Future, what makes time travel possible? Driving really fast, flux capacitor, the DeLorean, special engine fuel. 25 of you know that when Doc Brown stood on his toilet seat hanging a clock, no idea why he hung a clock over his toilet seat, by the way, he fell, he bumped his head. When he came to, he had this image in his head. He drew it on a napkin. It was the flux capacitor. It is what makes time travel possible. For those of you who think it's driving really fast, you need the flux capacitor. You also got to do 88 miles per hour. The DeLorean, it's just because you want to travel through time in style. And if you're writing on the main sheet, please erase it. I really don't want to have to exit this. Again, if you drew the yellow mark, please. Face it. Which of the following is not a geographical area of Israel? The Araba, the Negev, the Galilee, of that. That's right. Although it may be an Israeli term, the Ovda is actually a military air base located in the Ovda region of southern Israel. Guys, again, please, we're asking you, have a little respect. Don't draw on the screen. Every time you draw on it, we're going to have to restart it. So, guys, we're almost at the end. Here we go. Got Maddie, Lucas, Aiden, Alexa, Adam, all in the same order. A couple more questions to go. Here we go. In what year did Israel last host the Eurovision Singing Contest? 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020. 2019. Israel has participated in the Eurovision Contest 42 times. They've won it all 4 times. And with the last one coming in 2018, they were granted the host city in 2019. Congratulations. Leaderboard stays the same. Where was this Canadian artist born? Let the video loop in. Here we go. Justin Bieber was born in London, Ontario, raised in Stratford, started his career on YouTube, proud Canadian, but the Biebs was indeed born in London, Ontario. Congratulations to the 8 people, the true believers. Lucas, you are on fire right now and you're coming in at number 2. 2 more questions to go. What is Cardi B's real name? Anika, Stephanie Joanne, Amethyst, Amelia, Bella Cassis, Marlinus. 13 of you knew that Bella Cass, Marlinus, Almanzar is in fact Cardi B. Onika Tanya Mirage, it's actually Nicki Minaj. Stephanie Joanne Angelina Germanota is actually Lady Gaga. And Amethyst Amelia Kelly is, where's David? Let's unmute David. David.
I'm here.
Who is our third mystery name?
I don't know. Tell me.
David, you studied this. We asked everyone else to watch their videos. I asked you to study one thing and one thing only.
I failed, Phil. I failed.
Iggy Azalea. Congratulations to the 13 people who knew Cardi B. I would, in fact, do the Cardi B noise, but I can't. But I do have to stop sharing the screen because somebody keeps drawing on it. Guys, we have one, maybe two questions left. Please let us get to the end. You can draw on your screens all you want when this is over. Here we go. Let's check out our leaderboard. Still sitting the same. This is it, guys. We're coming down to the wire. Here we go. Last question. Who sings this 2020 Israeli summer hit? From the song Tel Aviv to this summer's 2020 hit, Omer Adam keeps dropping those chart toppers for you to party to. Congratulations to the 30 people who got that right. So here's what's gonna happen, guys. We're gonna look at our leaderboard. We're gonna crown us some champions, and then I'm gonna give away the last random prize. I have a couple of goodbye messages for you. So guys, before we get to all that, I wanna thank you all for watching the videos. Being pretty well behaved tonight, aside from a little bit of drawing, which I'm not gonna lie, if I was in grade 7, I probably would have been that kid doing it myself. So guys, congrats for playing. Thank you for playing. Let's take a look at our leaderboard. Let's crown some champions. Give us a minute to get all the names in, and we're gonna name us our last random person. So, in third place, Alexa Weiss. Coming in at number 2, Lucas Warwick, and our number 1 champion is Maddie Berman. Guys, congratulations to Lucas, Maddie, Alexa. Guys, congratulations to everybody else. We got through this. We weren't sure if they could be too hard. We were hoping they weren't going to be too easy. Congratulations. So what's going to happen now is we're going to just bear with us for a few minutes. Maybe in fact you want to speak now, say a couple of words to everyone, tell them a little bit about the education side of JNF while I calculate who is our final random draw winner.
Amazing. Hi everyone. It was wonderful to see teams from across Canada coming together. It was better if I saw your faces. Maybe I will see some familiar faces that I already saw at class, but it was great to see all the name and all the team from across Canada that coming together for something that bring all of us together, and is JNF and Israel. I want to say thank you for all the organization that collaborated with us today. All the Jewish schools, the camps, the Chibur Israeli in Miles Nadal in Toronto, and all the other wonderful people that help us to promote this wonderful evening. With all the people that just won all the great prizes, don't worry, we will be in touch with you tomorrow morning and finalize how we are going to ship you all the great prizes. And of course, thank you for the wonderful team of JNF that helped us to bring together this amazing night. So We all hope to see you in person next year and not just in Zoom. Thank you for coming tonight.
Thank you, Yifat. Before we get to our last random draw, let's talk to our winners from tonight. Maddie.
Hi.
How you doing? You won.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I'm feeling good. Thanks,
Maddie, for asking. Turn your camera on. Turn your camera on. Let's talk face to face.
Am I doing this? Oh, there's tape on my camera. Sorry. Okay. Is this working?
Hi.
Sorry, my Wi-Fi's a bit bad because like the Wi-Fi broke, so I'm on like a cellular data thing.
Don't
like,
stress. Don't stress. I just want to say congratulations. You feel good?
Yeah.
Congratulations. Like Yifat said, we're going to be in touch with you. I hope you use the real name that you registered under. So I'm going to email you. We're going to get in touch. We're going to figure out about getting you your grand prize. Sound good?
Yeah. Thank you.
Amazing. Congratulations. Thanks for playing. Lucas. Let's get Lucas out here.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good. I'm good.
You just won the second prize.
Yeah, it was
even
a close
though what you won?
No.
Galit, tell Lucas what he won.
Well, I think it's a question for Yifat, but I'm pretty sure it's the Sony
headphones.
Yes. Wireless headphones. I don't know if you're into gaming. This will come in handy for sure.
Lucas, yes. You DJ?
No, I'm not DJ.
Learn to DJ. I had those exact same headphones back when I started DJing. We're just using for music. Sell them on Amazon. Congratulations, man. Okay, you just won. Congrats, Lucas, man. Thanks for playing. And finally, to our third winner.
Woohoo!
Galit's excited about this one. Galit, I'll let you congratulate.
Hi.
Congrats, Alexa. Where are you from?
I'm Thornhill.
Thornhill. All right. Another Torontonian. Amazing. Are you having you on?
Yeah.
You know what you won?
No.
Yifat, what did she win?
Of $100 at Indigo. No,
it's she won in a Catan, the game. Oh. Play with all your family. So it's good for a coronavirus time. So enjoy with that.
Thank you.
Alexa, congratulations. Thank you for playing. So like I said, guys, we actually do have one more random draw to give away. So with that being said, let's put it into the random draw. And here we go. The fifth and final random draw winner of a $20 Indigo card is Eden Bitton. Eden, congratulations. You just won $20 to Indigo. Enjoy it, spend it wisely. Before we say goodnight, guys, Galit, any last words for our participants?
Just really thank you for participating. We're so happy you all joined us. Stay tuned for some more things virtual coming this summer. And thank you for encouraging and for supporting JNF. And we hope you will become future leaders of your communities wherever you are and support Israel from wherever you are. It is our homeland, and with you and with your help, we all build Israel together. So thanks, guys.
Guys, thank you, everybody. You just have to say thumbs up or thumbs down. Lance, I'm looking at you. Anything you want to say to everyone before? Guys, Lance Davis, the CEO of JNF Canada. Here we go.
Guys, thanks so much for participating. We're wrapping it up. We're going to do lots of events for education through the summer, through next year. So we hope to see you around. As Yifat said, hopefully face-to-face, but in the meantime, we'll use Zoom.
Thank you, Lance. Once again, guys, thank you everybody for playing. Hope you guys had a great time. Congratulations to all of our winners. If you didn't win, hope you still had a great time. We'll be doing this again. Stay tuned and have a great night. Bye, guys.
Good night. Bye, everyone.